fair to say that corporations all over the world are desperate to generate innovation. Creativity is a huge part of that, obviously. And that's why I'm here to talk about what drives innovation. And diversity drives innovation. When I say diversity, I mean it broadly. I'm talking about it in terms of industries and fields, yes, but also cultures and ethnicities. I'm going to show you examples from all of that. Let me give you one example, straight from the intersection. A couple of years ago, an architect named Mick Pierce received this curious challenge from Old Mutual, an insurance company in Africa, South Africa, in fact. He was to build the largest office complex, actually real estate complex, period, in Harare, the capital of Zimbabwe. But he had to do it without using an air conditioner. Well, this is a neat little trick, because it can get kind of hot in Harare, capital of Zimbabwe. But he managed to do it. And he did it by trying to understand how termites build their hills, their mounds on the African savanna. It termites need to keep an exact 87 degrees Fahrenheit inside of these mounds in order to grow a fungi which help they can digest wood. But the temperature on African savanna drops to below 40 degrees at night, or rises to over 100 degrees during the day. So how do you do it? How do the termites manage to do it? Well, what they do is they build these vents around the mound, just like this, and then they redirect air breezes into these vents, into a cool pool of mud at the bottom of the mound, and they circulate this air up, just like that. And by opening and closing vents constantly, they can keep an exact 87 degrees Fahrenheit side of that mound. So Mick Pierce looked at this and said, I can use the same principle for my building in Harare, which is what he did. Eastgate is the largest building in Zimbabwe. It has no AC unit, which saved him $4 million right off the bat, and uses up about 90% less energy than any other building around it. And has a temperature of between 73 to 76 degrees Fahrenheit. Now, how did Mick Pierce think of this? It wasn't because he was an expert in architecture, and he certainly was not an expert in termite ecology. But he combined these two fields. And when he stepped into the intersection of these two fields, he broke new ground. And that is what we can all do. I call what happens at the intersection of different industries, fields, and cultures the Medici effect. And it comes from the Medici family, which ruled the city of Florence some 500 years ago. They did lots of stuff there. They assassinated people. They plotted to take over the Pope in Rome, and they did that even. So I'm not going to talk about that. But they also sponsored creative individuals from lots of different disciplines. Sculptors, architects, painters, scientists, philosophers. Leonardo da Vinci was one of the most famous people that they sponsored from all over Europe, even as far away as China. And they brought them to the city of Florence, where they were able to break down the barriers between the different cultures, between the different disciplines, and collaborate to ignite what became one of the most creative eras in Europe's history, the Renaissance. So this is not about the Renaissance or the Medici family, but it is about the effect that they created and how we can create the same effect in the companies and organizations that we work with.